Hey traders, Raghee here, and in tonight's free video, I'm going to do something a little bit different. And that is, there's a lot of confusion and concern about follow through in the broader averages. You know, where are we with the S&P? Are we going to take out that double top, and are we going to see brand new highs again? You know, is there enough resiliency in this market to really commit to the NASDAQ futures themselves and any of the heavily weighted sectors and stocks within it? Same thing goes the Dow, same thing for the Russell, etc. So when there's this much confusion in the broader averages and I'm not at the overbought or oversold edge for the averages, what do you do? You know, what are ways that you can still find opportunity? Well, one thing I like to remind every index futures trader is that if you're trading index futures, NQ, ES, YM, RTY, you're actually a stock trader. You're kind of a stock futures trader, because inside every NQ is what? The contract. Microsoft, Amazon, Apple, Facebook, tech, communications, consumer discretionary, as far as the sectors go. So if you just look a little bit deeper within the fact that you're really a stock trader with leverage, playing the NASDAQ or the S&P futures, you can take that same approach and start looking at some of the more resilient, and I'm going to take you on over to XLP here, some of the more resilient sectors. And one of the places that I find some really decent resilience, and especially in an environment of uncertainty, is the XLP. Now, a lot of you in the futures room know that we have been bullish for the better part of coming up on a year on different long bond short yield ETFs, and we'll go into a lot more detail on those outperformers, which have done great. But in that list, a little further down, has been the consumer staple, or XLP. And so we look for relative outperformance. So I'm going to give you two names to keep an eye on here in the next, next few days, next few weeks. If we continue to get pullbacks in names like PG, I would highly recommend buying those pullbacks into the wave. The blue to green transitions have been great. The other individual name within the XLP that is a relative outperformer to the upside has been Walmart. So again, those blue to green transitions into the wave have been good. Not as good as Procter & Gamble, not as established, but certainly these are two of the better names within the XLP. So when there's a lot of confusion in the broader averages, go look for where the clarity and the commitment is, and then go look for opportunities there. You know, and there, it can work both ways. For quite some time in the futures room, we've been focused on relative underperformers too, and a lot of folks have been looking at things like PM and MO. Well, today we get news that they're not going to be seeking the merger, but look, these have been downtrends. Look at all the red grab candles. These have been downtrends for a very, very long time. So today's news really doesn't do much more than sort of put an exclamation point on the fact that in corrections of the downtrend in MO and in overbought resistance zones like what we have right now in PM, you do have a pocket of weakness you can take advantage of in that same ETF. So I hope this helps. Remember, if you're a futures trader, you really are able and nimble, fluent and fluid enough to trade everything, because commodities and also currencies affect everything. And you throw market trends on top of it, and making sure you're focused on ETFs and stocks and even the options chains related with enough liquidity, you know, there's no boundaries as to what you're able to trade. And this is one of the ways that I do it in the futures room. All right, gang, I'll see you in the next update.